Hi, I'm Jessica with Creative Minds. Today we're going to take a closer look at the onboarding plugin tool for your WordPress site. The term onboarding has evolved from corporate training ideas. Basically, trainers wanted new employees to guide themselves through their learning process. The Creative Minds onboarding plugin does just that. With our plugin, you will be able to create a help menu that will guide your visitors through your website. In this video, I will show you how to use the onboarding settings to create customized help menus for your WordPress site. So let's get started. From the Creative Minds website, download the pro version of the onboarding plugin. There is a free version available. However, many of the custom features discussed in this video are only available in the pro version, such as a variety of help icon options, adding a search field, and creating a unique header or footer. After you download and install the plugin for your WordPress site, you will find the CM onboarding plugin under your dashboard. In this video, I will create multiple help menus for an educational website. However, the onboarding plugin can be used for a wide variety of web content or site themes. This tool will help users search for important information and find links to external content. Selecting Add New Item allows you to enter the data which will be displayed in the rollout widget. Right now, I'm going to make a help menu which will appear on one specific page of my website, the syllabus page. Imagine if this page provided a lot of details. I might need to create several help menu items to guide my site visitors through all that information. The widget search features will help your users quickly find those important details without having to search through the entire help menu. I'm going to title this help menu Syllabus Guide. In the content area, I will add terms that our site visitors might enter into a search field. Then I will select Syllabus under the page drop-down menu. Now my help menu will only appear on the syllabus page. So when I preview this help menu, I can see the three help items. In the search field, if I enter Future, only the third entry containing this keyword will appear. You may control various features of the search option under the plugin settings. On the General tab, you have the option to turn the search feature on and off. Under the Labels tab, you can edit the text visible in the search field. By default, a user will see the message, "No item has been found," if their search is not successful. I'm going to change this message to "No results." You may also change the search input label and the text placeholder. Now, when I preview the widget on the syllabus page and enter a term that is not found within the help menu, the message "No results" will appear in the search box. The changes made under the plugin settings apply to each instance of the widget throughout the site. This does not mean that your help menu will be identical on every page. You may create multiple help menus and apply them to either a specific page or the entire site. On the help item page, you even have the option to override some of the global settings if necessary. Here I have my main help menu. This help menu appears on all the pages throughout the site, with the exception of the Customize Syllabus help menu. The first item contains basic text. Another item contains a video viewable within the plugin window. And a third item is actually a web link. At the bottom of this help item screen, I am able to select Show on Every Page. Now I have two separate help menus. One is displayed on several pages throughout the website, and the other is displayed only on the syllabus page. To make it easier for my site visitors to determine that this is a unique help menu on the syllabus page, I'm going to add a custom header. Custom headers and footers are a good way to add a special title or disclaimer to your help menu. For this header, I would like to add an image. In the header content area, I will click on Add Media and insert a custom image. This feature is a great way to add a logo or possibly a photo representing the information in your help menu. In the footer section, I will also add a small message. Now when I preview this help menu, you will see that the new header and footer appear on the syllabus help guide. Other customization options are available under the settings menu. At the top of the page, you will find several different help icons. If one of these icon options does not work for your website's theme, then you may use your own icon. You can also easily change the position of the icon and the location of the rollout widget. And you may select from a black or white help menu theme. Setting the size of the widget is important because you will likely need to adjust these settings to complement the design and layout of your site. In this case, the widget is 320 pixels wide. When it rolls out, it covers the rightmost column, but does not overlap the main body of the web page. Last, I'm going to hide the title of the help menus because I prefer to use a custom header. By changing a few settings, this help menu has changed from this to this. Notice how the color complements the web design. And on the syllabus page, the imported graphic makes a nice header. Another feature of the onboarding plugin is the template tool. The template features give you the ability to add the same information to several different help widgets. To add the template, I am going to edit my help items, scroll to the bottom of the page, and click on Add Help Item. Under the template drop-down menu, I will select the About This Course template item and apply that template. Then I will repeat the process to add the same information to my other help menu. Now, if I need to update that information, it's easy to make the changes on the template page, which will instantly update all of the help menus throughout the site. Perhaps your website may need several different menus. With all the customization options available, you could have a completely different help menu on every page within your WordPress site. Depending on your audience, you may decide to use the accordion style list to provide information. Or perhaps you would like to display a mix of text or multimedia arranged in the slider media style. Maybe the select widget style would create a nice frequently asked question drop-down help menu. Or the slide widget style could effectively provide a step-by-step list to complete a task. The CreativeMinds onboarding plugin is easy to use and highly adaptable. Use the pro version of this plugin and you will be able to customize the look, location, content, and interactive features of your help menus. I'm Jessica for CreativeMinds. Thanks for watching.